evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Mr. Anonymous broadcasting. It is April 8th, 2010. We are about a month away from the election in Union City. I have one question for you tonight. And this is a serious question. And it's geared towards the Brian Stack supporters and, you know, some of the drones you can't change for the Brian Stack drones from Turkey. So you can't touch, you can't change those people's minds. But to the people that are, you know, well, he seems nice and he does stuff. These are facts I'm about to lay out on the table for you guys. Facts. Straight facts. There's 15% unemployment in this town, Union City. We have the most violent schools in the county. Okay? We have a serious gang infestation in this town. Alright? We have intimidation. Me personally speaking, I'm not speaking for anyone else, but my billboard was ripped down 3 times. So we have a political intimidation problem in this town. Okay? These are facts. What happened to me is a fact. Okay? The percentage of unemployment is a fact. Alright? The fact that the schools are the most violent is a fact. Okay? The fact that we have the most, you know, on top of that, one more thing also, over the last 10 years, the property taxes have increased over 40%. Not in 1 year, over 10 years. Okay? So you have these four things. Okay, you have extremely high taxes, you have a gang crime problem, you have the most violent schools, okay, and you have 15% unemployment. These are facts, okay, to the supporters, and even the drones, listen to me, these are facts, right? So now, if you think that is good governing, then what do you think is great governing? 30% unemployment? The schools in an out-and-out rumble every day, 70% property taxes increases, is that what you would be defined as great governing? Because this is the thing about Brian Stack, okay? I'm going to give the guy credit here right now. He's a good politician. He's a great politician, a great Hudson County politician. But he is not a governor. He does not know how to govern. He knows how to rule. He knows how to rule his flock. You know, his followers, his drones. But when it comes to governing the citizens as a whole, he just don't know what he's doing. Because 15% of us are unemployed. Our children that are in the school, some of them are dealing with violence on a day-to-day basis. In the streets, we're dealing with gangs. Okay, maybe the supporters, the so-called supporters of Brian Stack, don't mind that. Okay, if that's the way you want to live your life, fear, okay, and you know, having your property tax raised, but there are a percentage of us that don't want that, okay? And there's nothing that man does to address these issues, okay? I haven't done this show in a while, but it's a month now. We're a month away. Now we're going to start turning it up a little bit. We're going to start putting the pedal to the metal, as my boy Mr. Burt Reynolds said in Smokey and the Bandit, right? Get out there. Start talking with your neighbors. There's only one other option out there, and it's not because I worked for them or anything else of that matter. Frank Scowfile and the Vision for Union City ticket. They're out there. The only ones going against Brian Stack. So at least give them a shot. Listen to what they have to say. I mean, Frank is a superintendent of schools. Another guy works in the corrections department, knows about gangs, knows how they operate. You know what I'm saying? Excuse me. Another person, the rest of them all private. One's a businessman, a lifelong citizen of Union City. You know, they have a good eclectic group of people that are common people with common sense solutions, at least what I've heard from them. So at least give them a shot. Hear them out. And like I said before, great politician, Hudson County politician for that matter. I don't know if that's saying much about the guy, but he knows how to maneuver. You know, he knows how to give a little bit to this guy, he gets a little bit from that guy, and he gets what it is. But he doesn't know how to fix problems. Okay? He does not know how to fix the issues that plague this city. And that's bottom line. The people that support him are on the payroll. I don't mean that as a knock. That is a fact. His majority, you take away all the city workers, and, you know, he's really got no one voting for him. Okay, just keep that in mind. So the supporters of Brian, this is your chance to stand up and be an individual. And just flex your American muscles of freedom and liberty and the right to vote for who you want to. Don't be persuaded or intimidated or forced. Or, you know, I might lose my job, or whatever. You don't have to let them know who you're supporting in public. get behind in that booth and flip that other level. Column A, the only other one against column B, which is the column Brian. I mean, the guy's even got a name. This is the whole column with the letter B. His name is Brian. Come on. You gotta shake up the tree a little bit. It's gonna happen this November with Congress. Anybody that follows this knows this. Let's start our own little mini liberty revolution right here in New York City. May 11th, so column A, get out there. Stop the tyranny of Brian Stack. I don't mean that as a knock or whatever they're calling us right now, racist, fearmongers. I just mean it as a fact. He's just a bad person. He doesn't know how to govern the city. Great politician. And I'm sure there's another job out there in the world in this field, but mayor of a town is not one of them, especially during times like this. Ladies and gentlemen, once more, this is Mr. Anonymous. Get out there, vote. May 11th, column A, or anyone else for that matter. Just not Brian's.